So, correct. Head nut socket. Incorrect. That's how my that's how shit goes for me. So I will take this one back when I take all the cores back. But anyway, yeah, you know, that's that. I just thought that that was the right one, but I already dry fit this one, so it fit just fine. So I'm digging on that, and so back at it I will go.
Gonna be out with the old, in with the new today.
All right, so I've got this thing. It, it is a reverse thread, but man, you got to put some serious inward pressure to get that nut socket to seal into this nut. Piece. So, that's a good thing. Let me grab a, you know what, these videos are kind of more for me, so I don't feel like such an idiot standing out here, kneeling out here talking to myself. So, but I was surprised last night, man. I was up. I'm always up real late, just can't sleep, but anyway, I got one subscriber, so bless you, man. But these are more therapy for myself than anybody, but you want to subscribe, subscribe away, man. But I appreciate it, and, it's all good. So now I gotta see what's going on with this guy. Now, I've never tore into this, so I'm just kind of doing it. Let me grab a mate. Man, if I gotta go back to Napa at the end of the day, I've been there. Like, I told the homes at the counter, I said, I think I bumped into that guy once before over there. He doesn't remember me. But I've been there now 3-4 times in the last 2 freaking days. And I told the dude, man, I was like, you know, I said, I haven't seen you pretty much in my entire life, and now I see seen you more in the last 2 days than I kind of see my own. So that's the way it goes. It gives me an excuse to get out on such a nice day, man. Awesome day out. So I think that this thing, I think I have a hammer in this side of it. Shelby, look up here. So Shelby came in. Hi, Shelby's. She came into the shop with her little nubby cigar-looking red bone. Where'd you go, Shelbers? Huh? Shelby. Shelby. What you doing? Shelby. What you doing? She's a good girl. Alright, so I think, man, this is just a matter of getting that freaking thing off of there. Shelby dog here. Had a slight interruption there. I got the cam position sensor, which is going to be the bane of my existence. I really wasn't looking forward to that thing getting here. But it's here, so I'll have to deal with that. DFH. Big hammer. Alright. Bigger hammer. So, I told you we'd have to put some new fucking bearing in this. Why did that shit come off? Oh man, I hate gear room. I will try to watch my language, but no promises. I haven't thrown anything yet, so I guess I'm mellowing out in my old age. Well, that's the eBay crap. That's what I was after. Works every time. Big effing hammer and duct tape. I think if a man had a big hammer, duct tape, and bacon, he could survive a Holocaust or even the coronavirus. So, what a glorious day. I can't believe that this is March. Was it March? Yeah, it's already March, but I know last year we had a pretty good snow at the end of March, so I'm not counting my eggs yet. I'm not counting something yet, but it's a pretty awesome day out, that's for sure. Makes me just want to go fire up one of my rides and just go for a cruise. But I got too much done, that's for sure, so I'm heading out here to the shop. So, I'm in the shop. I got the, just FYI, I did get the, I got the intake marked, and my buddy Jack came by and dropped off a milling tool. So, as soon as I get done with my mandatory repairs, I'll start on this next. I started cleaning off my bench area over there. I told you, man, stuff sometimes just gets in a mess, and then it's that. What do I need, a pick? What was I, oh yeah, for those springs. I'm gonna turn the light on, get my sunglasses off here, see what get some lights on in here, see if I can I think it would be over here. Look at that. Look at that. Do. So I got that. Needed that. I might as well just take like one of these sets. I got this set here. I got like duplicate. Oh man. All over here. I got a lot of duplicate tools. I got a lot of duplicate tools. I think I have another set. Wrong drawer. Yeah, see, I got another set of various picks and things right there. So I'm gonna leave that one over here. And I'll take this one with me over to the other shop. Yeah, right on. What a day, huh? Look at this. This is just an awesome day. Awesome possum. So that's my pasture areas over there. And I'll take you back there sometime. I've been cleaning. I've been doing a lot of cleaning. When I say cleaning, I mean you could not walk through that when we first bought this property. But now you can. I'm about half done. 60% done, somewhere in there. But that's the stall barn for the popos. And there's the garage. The detached, I call it. And this is my, when I say the room of doom, this is my room of doom back here. It like is collection point for all things that I gotta store. Oh, I left my lights on in here. So those are empty boxes there, but you know, stuff, my compressor is there. It's all plumbed into the other side of the shop, so that's nice to have. But those are Torino parts. There's some of my Torino suspension, various things. I got some wheels in here, stuff to go up for sale. I don't know, I hate selling stuff. I hate dealing with people on that, but I got a Polaris clutch tool, removal tool, electric lock for 2004, tailgate Ford F-150, just various stuff I'm starting to collect because I think we will be moving, downsizing. And I got plenty of downsize, that's for sure. There's a door for my Bronco. I caved the door in on my big Bronco, slid into a tree out in the trails. That thing's a beast. I got to start working on it too, so be seeing that shortly. Ooh, I know what I can take with me while I'm here. Good memory. I'll take this one. I have two of these as well. Just poked the crap out of me. Man, this thing's heavy as crap. I have to use two. So, that was the Room of Doom. All kinds of stuff. I actually have a couple of kits I need to put on. I got an airbag kit and dual remote oil filter kits for, I can put it on the Excursion or I can put it on the F-350. The intentions, well, I've got the Firestones already on the Excursion. The intention was to put all that on the F-350 for a little logistics business. I had a Freightliner sport chassis. I just sold it a couple of months ago. It was just sitting. I wasn't driving it. And unfortunately, man, it's an awesome truck. It was all decked out. You know, wood interior, limo lights, 1,000-watt stereo. It was loaded up.
rear bed or the rear seat folded down into a bed. It was a nice ride, man. It was a nice ride, but sold it to some friends out in Montana. They'll use it. It wasn't getting used here. So, all right, back at it. Right on. Well, my methods are unconventional just because I'm inept. I got it off. Man, I'm telling you. This is the worst doing this piece out of all of this crap. So that was, let me see. That one just bit the dust. It was actually a pretty good pad on it, but these things just got head up.
So away with those. I got some cleanup to do in here. Calendar and tried to avoid getting anything jacking up that seal there. See, there's a bit of corrosion right here. This thing, 20 years old, man. I kept this thing indoors a lot. I did have to sit out for a little while, but it does amaze me in some areas how much
rust there is.
I've always tried to take good care of it. Some of the stuff looks worse than what it really is, but I guess after 20 years, shit starts to happen, Especially with the salting on the roads, I know a lot of states, municipalities are getting rid of the salting, but you go to these saline solutions and that kind of stuff. But anyway, it's amazing sometimes how much corrosion starts, once it sets in, it starts just compounding exponentially. But this is still in damn good shape. This is a desirable vehicle, man. I get, times when I've had to go down to the Ford house, get stuff done there. It's amazing how many times I get asked if I want to sell this. 7.3, man, these Excursions, the early model Excursions before they went to the, what was it, the 6-liter. 6.4, something like that. They had some really bad years in there. And then they also went away from the leaf front and went to the coilovers. And I think the leaves for as far as actually using the ride is much better. The sun's on there. So I'm just going to scrape some of this stuff off of there. I got it pretty well. Probably squirt this down with some cano oil just to keep it rust inhibitor for a little while at least, make me feel better. Sometimes we do things that really don't change or affect change, but they make us feel better, so might as well just go ahead and do it. So it makes me feel better to spray the rust of it around here. So be it, man. It's worth it. Alright, so I gotta do some cleanup and get this thing tidied up, and then I will be back reassembling. So this is a pretty good oil. I bought a bunch of, they have all kinds of different fluids, but it's I believe they're down in Tennessee. And I like it. Pretty good stuff. Like I said, they've got various products, graphite, drive, a dry film PTFE type of thing. PTFE, something like that. And so it works out pretty well. We've also got some other type of oils and whatnot. I use it a lot on stuff like this, a couple of the pieces of equipment I have, a couple of tractors, a bobcat. Anyway, it just works handy to have around. I bought a whole box of just various fluids from them, and do like it. So if you happen to come across it, I ordered it online. Give it a try if you haven't. They send coupons every so often for sales, and sometimes you can get this can, a larger can, for the same price as the smaller cans. So anyway, that's that. I'm going to see about making sure this stuff can motivate around in here. I didn't buy a new kit for this, so I may get a container and clean up some of the stuff I have, the springs and the tensioner, and go from there. But it'll be better than what it was, that's for damn sure. Anyway, appreciate it, and be back at it. Okay, so it's cleanup time on parts, and so that's springs, and tensioner, piece parts. Should have just got a kit, but I didn't, and I'm not going back to Napa just to get that shit. So I need to get this stuff done. I'm not going to replace the seals. They all seem good. So I'm going to clean these parts up, put them back on there, button this side up, and caliper, pads, rotor, e-brake, shoes, and that'll complete this side. And I got the other side to do, and the sensor just got all kinds of crap to be doing. Gotta wrap this Excursion up, fuel things on the F-150, and then I gotta get back on the 540. Well, there we go. Cleaned up as well as I'm gonna clean that crap up. So back to the wheel. Install the e-brake, shoes, reverse the process. Fun times indeed. All right, so that is the emergency brake back. Pads back in action. So I didn't keep the video on because, you know what, it's pretty self-explanatory what has to happen. How it happens, I think, is a personal choice. So I don't know if mine was a conventional means to do it or not, but it worked, and it's on there. Cleaned up the springs, the retaining clips, the tensioner, put some anti-seize in there at the points of pivoting or movement, and that should do that side. All right, so now I'm going to take a little bit of gear oil. Just make sure I have a little bit of lube on it. If you know what I mean, you jelly beans. Cleaned it up pretty well, I do believe. Actually, what I think I may do is actually put a little bit of grease on that seal. That's not bad. Too.
that business out. I'm gonna put a little bit of grease on that seal. And I don't think I have any grease in the tub, but I don't have any, I got tub of grease on the, in the other shop, but don't have a tub of grease over here. But I do have a grease gun with grease in it. This is soap. Alright, so now is the moment of truth here, people. In this case, I may need the BFH, but I'd rather not use the BFH. Just to make sure I'm getting this, I gotta go grab a piece of wood. Okay, so I did get a bigger hammer. Well, I got my bigger hammer, but I also got a piece of wood. Let's see if this this was loose. And I took it off, so that sounds like a good fire. So I see why you gotta push on this. It's gotta get that nut's got to get below these detents. That's why you got to push on that thing. That. Just want to clean right here. Sky, the day dies.
that's all. I guess I can put the axle in, back in, and then the bend caliper. I might have to clean the caliper or the rotor up a little bit. All right, I gotta go get some RTV. All right, so I've got
steel wool. To listen to the words, he's like, tired of the buses, tired of the planes.
I've had to do a lot of traveling in my days. And
it's when you're young, full of all full of energy and piss and vinegar, yeah, it's fun. And as you start getting a little bit older, hotels become a pain in the ass, airports become a pain in the ass, airplanes become a pain in the ass, people become a pain in the ass. Travel loses its glory and glamour real quick. You know you travel too much when the bartenders in various bars and airports around the areas know you. You know, out in Denver, there's a restaurant, pub, out at the Denver International, Elways. And, my Elways people, man, they knew me coming, they'd see me coming, and they try to make room for me and have my drink set up. I didn't even have to ask, it was just there. People sitting around me were like, wow, look how you rate. Like, look how I rate. It's like, it's a sad, sad commentary. And, when bartenders in airports know you, man. That was sad commentary. I had some young guy one time. I hadn't been traveling for a while, so I lost a lot of my like my premier status and all that stuff. I gotta get a pick. Hey. Priority premier line was moving along pretty quickly, and the line I was in was not, and this younger guy in front of me, he was looking over there and he says, man, I wish we were in that line. And I said, nah, man, I don't. I said, I've been there. I said, the line we're in right now is for the people that have lines. I said, the line that those people are in, this is their life. I said, I trade priority. I have a trade priority. God bless this thing. I trade priority. Not having to wait. Versus having a life. I think taking a life. Having a life, not taking a life. Having a life is a little bit, and I haven't had this stuff open for a while. It's a bit more rewarding. Although I will say, I used to go first class a lot, and I still do if I gotta travel. I did the free drinks, and I did the legroom. That is nice. We run into some interesting people from time to time, traveling. Some of the best stories I have are traveling. You know, when I was on the road, like flipping a Benz in the middle of the UK, out in the middle of nowhere in the UK. I wasn't driving. I was in the passenger seat up front. A friend of mine, we'll just call him by his nickname,
no driving Aussie bastard whacked a old stone wall out in the middle of nowhere. And we wound up skirting down the road on the side in this bend, in this big bend. There was five of us. Friend of mine, Preston, and I, we had a good time in Amsterdam. Had a good time in a lot of places. Prague was pretty cool. Carried away, and I noticed
he's had a blue Loctite on him.
This is probably I'll have to go back over to the other shop, get some blue Loctite. Should have thought of that. Alright, maybe we'll do that. Maybe that. So that's Marvelous 18. Thank you. not fully tightened, but it's, I'm not sure what the torque specs are for those things. I should go look that up. I know one thing I can do. I hate not having a proper socket, metric socket for this, but. All right, so now I have a mess in front of me. Just to make sure I didn't run out. Right on. This is making me happy. All right. So, pads are on board. All right. A little bit more on there. Not a great deal. So, I'm hoping I can do this. This would be so cool getting this drippy son of a bitch off of here. That's all I can say. Right on. So now, I just hate when my hands are this way. Yeah. Think of that. That's metric. Woohoo.
Alright.
Guess what? Now, other than the bleeding, the bloodletting, crush worships. Alright, I gotta get my hands taken care of here. So, I got the brake done. I haven't put the tire on, so I'm cleaning the wheel off on it. I went to start the truck up, and it's dead. Why is it dead? Because I had to leave it in neutral, the key in it. I couldn't get the key out of it because I had that caliper off, and I couldn't mash the brakes to get it to go into park. I guess I could have crawled underneath and I don't know. Anyway, so now it's freaking dead. So now I got to charge it up. Yep, that's a kind of a pain in the ass. So it's on the charger. I guess I can go dry that tire and wheel off, get it stuck back up on there. Actually, I don't want to do that. I want to see about bleeding it first. I have a bleeding kit. Maybe I'll try the bleeding kit. There shouldn't be a whole lot of air in that line, because that line was dripping. The reservoir's got fluid in it, and this was a partially loaded caliper, so I shouldn't have much air to bleed off of this. So maybe that's what I'll do, is see what happens with the bleed. I don't think I've ever used my one-man bleeding kit, so I'll see if it's truly a one-man deal. So this is the box I just moved over here. This had been sitting in the room of doom for a number of years. 5 years. It's been sitting in there 5 years since I moved here. Manual, paperwork. This is it. So let's see what this thing holds. You know what? I might have used it once when I was dealing with something on the Torino, but we'll see. So I just see a bunch of crap. Tubes. Guess this is the gun that pulls the vacuum. Or that's the gun that pulls. Yeah, you could say pulls the vacuum. Pulls the vacuum. I guess these are the different potential reservoir covers. Yeah, I don't know what happened to my pamphlet for this thing. That's a good question. It's probably back there in the shop in the filing cabinet amongst all the other crap that's back there in that filing cabinet. I'll see if I can't figure this thing out and go from there. So I just did a quick, tried to do a quick bleed down. This hose doesn't fit on the, that hose doesn't fit on the Zerk, the bleeder nozzle, bleeder Zerk, whatever the hell you call it on the caliper. That hose doesn't fit it either. That hose doesn't fit it. I went out to the other shop. I had some fuel lines for some smaller pieces of equipment. None of that fit it. So I had to get a little help to do it with a two-person bleed. And I think it's down. All that drip again is from the drip. So I'm fixing to put this wheel back on it and call this side good. Ah, crap. I got to put that shield back on it. Well, I thought I was about done. Well, this is like the third time I've put the shield on. I had to take it off to get to the bleeder valve. That's it. The bleeder valve. That. It's. I gotta get hosed to fit it so my craftsman
vacuum pump cleaner thing works. That's our one sees on these things work. Refresh them a little bit. I gotta go get a torque wrench too. Ford recommends these to go down to 165 pounds, foot-pounds, and I think in part, because these,
for the longest time, I had problems with rotors warping, and I think in part, as I previously mentioned, the Excursion is based on a F-250, but this thing weighs quite a bit more than an F-250, so I think the brakes, same brakes, but I think the brakes were under-engineered, so the, I guess that extra tension, that extra tension or force on them taking the lug nuts to 165 foot-pounds helps keep these rotors from warping. But anyway, special Bolton said, I think it's like 162 to 165, something like that. But anyway, so that's what I'm going to take them down to, but I won't do that tonight. I'll just get the tire on and get them both down there for tonight and do a little cleanup, and I'll be back out at this tomorrow.
Ain't that fun?
So, one thing I'll say is, man, I got my issues with the French, but one thing I love, they have make a damn good tire. This Michelin, this LTX, I guess it's called the Defender now. My buddy Jack told me that, I had no clue that they were, I guess they were known as the LTX, not the Defender. But anyway, man, these tires, I've got them on the F-350, this is the second set I think I've had on this. I've gotten at every set, I think I got like 90,000. The ones on the F-350, the tread is still awesome, but they're getting so old, they're dry rotting, so I will have to replace them. But that kind of hurts doing six of them. That's an old school oil can right there. I hope it's still working. They moved it out here. Love old school stuff, man. Mechanical things, I kind of dig them. This oil, what it really does is just help you put consistent torque on the lug nuts, since these are integrated. Since these are integrated, kind of wash your lug nuts. You can see these wheels are kind of beat up, but these are the original wheels. So it happens after 20 years. Is playing Friday and Sunday night, two totally different sets. Pretty good lineup actually for the whole weekend. Kind of stoked about that. Thank you.
torque those later to the proper specifications. I'm just gonna clean shit up tomorrow. I'm a bit passed out today. That'll be time for the battery to just time for that battery to charge. Brake feels good, man. Brake pedal feels awesome. So, man, what a pain in the ass. That e-brake, those pads for the e-brake, sitting on the inboard side of the hub and whatnot, is just painful. I gotta make sure that rear end fluid is coming down the axle shaft to get at that bearing. I didn't feel any. I just heard that noise, but I didn't feel anything, and it wasn't like metal on metal scratching or screeching. So pretty confident it was just that bearing didn't lost some of its lubrication. So yahoo, man, what a day. So what a day.
Done for the day.